In this particular image, I'm going to focus mainly on the myelohyoid. Okay, so first of all, you should know that this muscle, it arises from the myelohyoid line of the mandible and it inserts into the fibrous raphe, okay, fibrous raphe and the hyoid bone. Yeah, median fibrous raphe and the adjacent part of the hyoid bone. Myelohyoid is also called as the oral diaphragm or the diaphragm of oral cavity. Okay, so and myelohyoid is innervated by the nerve to myelohyoid, which is a branch of inferior alveolar nerve, which is a branch of mandibular nerve, that is V3 division of fifth cranial nerve. Okay, it supplies myelohyoid. Also, now the actions of myelohyoid. Now see, action can be anywhere. For example, if the hyoid bone is fixed, okay, then it will do, it will pull towards this direction. So it will depress the mandible. Okay, if the hyoid is fixed, but if the mandible is fixed, then it will pull the hyoid forward. Okay, and also in that case, it will alleviate the oral cavity. If the mandible is fixed, okay, it will pull the hyoid bone forward. And third action is it supports and alleviates the oral cavity. Myelohyoid, I am repeating, it is the oral diaphragm, origin from myelohyoid line of the mandible, insertion into the median fibrous raphe and the body of hyoid bone. Actions, it supports and alleviates the floor of oral cavity. Second action, if the mandible is fixed, it pulls the hyoid forward. Third action, if the hyoid is fixed, it depresses the oral cavity, it depresses the mandible, and its innervation is through the nerve to myelohyoid, which is a branch of inferior alveolar nerve, which is again a branch of mandibular nerve, that is V3 division of trigeminal nerve. About genioglossus, I will talk later, but you should know that genioglossus is the safety muscle of tongue. Okay, and myelohyoid is the oral diaphragm. Clear?